Hello everyone, this is Dr. Kripal Srinivasa, an MBBS MD. MD being specialized in the pharmacology. And today I'll be talking about writing the review of literature. The review of literature forms an essential part of your thesis, as well as review of literature. So, the review of literature, it forms an essential part of your thesis, as well as review of literature forms an essential part of any review article. So, what I'll do is, my focus out here is mainly on the review of literature that we tend to write in the as a part of our dissertation, and that is what I'll be talking about. And I'll be highlighting few steps that are essential for writing the review of literature, and hope that I am able to solve or I'm able to justify the needs or the pattern of writing of review of literature. If by the end of the session I am able to do this, my purpose of giving this presentation would be half solved. So when we write about the review of literature, this session I would like to give you an insight into what is the importance of review of literature, what are the steps involved in writing a review of literature, and would like to invoke a sense of critical thinking, writing and planning of components of review of literature. So we start with what exactly is a review of literature. If we go by the definition, at this moment I am not trying to differentiate between the review of literature that is done for as a part of a dissertation or for writing a review article. So as such, a literature review is when we are trying to review the articles. So this means that we are trying to survey scholarly articles, books and other sources, which could be maybe dissertation of other students, conference proceedings, which are relevant to a particular area, particular issue, an area of research or theory. So this review of literature provides a short description and critical evaluation of work that is critical to the topic or that is important to the topic, and it offers an overview of significant amount of literature that has been published on a particular topic. So this review of literature is essential as it helps us to identify what has already been done on this subject or a particular topic. It helps us evaluate the extent to which a specific research area has revealed any specific interpretable trends or patterns, and it also helps accumulate empirical findings that are related so that we can narrow down our research question to support the best evidence-based practice. It would help us in generating new framework and theories, and it would help us in identifying topics or questions that require more investigation. So this review of literature could be a section in the journal, such as a review of article, or it could be a part of your dissertation, such as a chapter in thesis. So my focus today would be on chapter in thesis or dissertation, and I hope I would be able to clarify some aspects related to this writing this review of literature. And review of literature always creates a solid starting point for all members of the committee that are interested in a particular area. That means that it is a work that is done in collaborative efforts. So literature review is a critical analysis of whatever is existing, and it tends to highlight both the strength and weaknesses of a particular research topic. which could be essential or which is critical to understand the field. And if you go through this particular literature thoroughly, we might have opportunities to think about what has been done, what are the similarities, the patterns, the trends and differences that exist across the research, and we can identify what has been done and what needs to be done. That means we are trying to identify the lacunes that are there in the literature, and that could help us or justify our research question. The gap in literature would be the justification that the reason for your doing the research. Now, when you talk about this literature review, it has a structure. Now, this structure consists of three broad areas: the introduction, the body, the conclusion, and recommendation. So, this is true for all the articles that we tend to scan or that we tend to go through. In the introduction, it tends to give you a quick idea of the topic of the literature review, such as what was the central theme or the organizational pattern, what did this particular study do, and what did this particular study reveal, or what has been done and what are the lacunes that could not be addressed, or what are the things that demand further investigation. These things are the areas that we need to search in when we are talking about review of literature. Now, the various steps involved in the literature review process are: the first thing that you need to do is you need to formulate the research question and write down the objectives. You need to search the extent of literature that is available. You need to screen for inclusion. You need to assess the quality of primary studies. You need to extract data as well as analyze the data. And this is what we will be discussing in the coming slides about all these aspects one by one. So first we talk about formulating the research question and objectives. So we start with, generally what happens is we start with a broader area and we narrow down to a particular area of research. And for this we have to be very thorough with the articles that we are scanning or the literature that we are scanning. So this research question is the key ingredients that guide you for the reverse review methodology, and this underscores the type of information that is needed. It informs the search for and selection of relevant literature, which would be specific for your particular topic, and it would guide or orient you for the subsequent analysis of the research question. The formulating is important. Now, the next thing is you have to search for the extent of literature, and when we talk about searching the extent of literature, we need to have certain strategies that could be used for searching the literature, and these strategies are: it could be exhaustive coverage, which ensures that all relevant studies that have been done to date till this particular point of time are included in the review, and conclusion is based upon the all inclusive knowledge that has been given from this study. And mind you, this is not a one time process. Review of literature keeps on moving further. Maybe when we talk about writing out the dissertation, we have a time span for maybe an MD or PhD of 1.5 to 3 years, and by that time, 1.5 to 3 years after your presentation of protocol to the time you start writing your thesis, a lot of new things might be added to the existing literature. So you have to have an exhaustive coverage, and your presenting material should be representative of most of other work that is given in this particular field or area. And sometimes what we tend to do is we tend to just select top tier journals. That is not a true process, that is not an ideal process of scanning for literature. You have to search all the available data that is available, that is there. It could be in different languages and in maybe journals that are not there, or journals that are not top tier journals, or maybe it could be something that is there in the books or something that is there in the newspaper. So everything has to be searched for. Then you have to concentrate on the prior work. So there should be empirical studies or conceptual papers that can initiate a particular line of investigation. And this particular, when you talk about this particular line of investigation, it changes the problem and how these questions are framed, as well as it introduces the new methods or concepts and tends to engender in it an important debate that is required for, or that is an essential step for, review of literature. Then you have to go for screening of inclusion. So if you go by a search on any of the various search engines and you type any particular subject, let's say diabetes or anything, you get a lot of research papers, a lot of papers that have been done on that particular topic. So you cannot include each and everything, because when you include each and everything, you are tending to be more vague, and it might not be an area of or interest to you. So you have to set a predetermined rules of what are the various things that you would try to include for a particular topic. Let's say if we are talking about the diabetes disease such as diabetes mellitus. So when we are talking about disease such as diabetes mellitus, in this particular situation, you need to do certain things that are important. You cannot go for, you need to type another word, because when we say diabetes itself is a very broad area, whether you are looking for therapy, whether you are looking for complications, you are looking for long-term complications, you are looking for short-term complications, or you are looking for the prevalence or incidence. So all these things tend to vary, and you have to have a predetermined rule for this. You have to enhance objectivity, and it is always better to have two independent persons if there is any bias or any agreement is not reached. So, and there should be a process that is required to resolve the disagreement between two persons. The next step that is involved is assessing the quality of primary study. You need to assess the scientific quality of the selected study. And when we talk about the scientific quality, it refers to the rigor of the research design and the methodology. Maybe if we talk about research design, was this particular study an open label study, a double blind study, a single blind study, was it a placebo control study, was it a non-inferiority trial or a superiority trial or whatever it was. And what was the methodology that was employed in this particular study? You have to have all these things set beforehand. You need to ascribe quality scores through domain-based evaluation, and this would be based on study component designed and executed appropriately to reflect on the extent to which the selected study addresses the possible biases and maximizes the validity. Once you have done this, then you need to extract the data. You need to gather or extract applicable information from each primary study included. You need to have a focus on your initial research question. Don't tend to go haywire. Don't tend to deviate from your initial research question. And you need to have an information about how, when, where, and by whom the primary study was conducted, what was the research design and method, or qualitative or quantitative results that should be collected. The next step is analyzing and synthesizing data, where you tend to analyze whatever interpretation that has been there in the study and how to proceed further. So in this particular step, you need to collate, summarize, aggregate, organize, and compare the evidence extracted from the included study, and it has to be presented in a meaningful way. So what you need to do is, you'll have to provide a coherent lens to make sense of extant knowledge on a particular given topic, provided that you are trying to address a lacunae or you are trying to address a gap for that particular topic. So whenever you are conducting a literature review, it will help you determine if the proposed research is actually needed. When you look for many studies and you will see that there are a lot of studies, you have a particular idea in mind and you go for a thorough research, you find there are a lot of studies already published, and when you look into these studies, you will find that there are certain lacunes that were not addressed by these studies. So you can look into those lacunes, or you could take care of those lacunes and you could address the question accordingly. So always we start, whenever we are talking about as I have highlighted previously, we are talking about, we broadly start with the topic and we narrow down to a problem. So it can be overwhelming getting into the literature of a field of study. A literature review can help you understand where you need to focus your effort, and at the same time your literature review would help generate hypothesis or questions for further studies. So when you talk about your own literature review, the first thing that you need to keep in mind is what are the key players in your field. When we talk about key players, there are certain authors who have markedly done research in a particular area. So we have to recognize those key players, and these key players could be anything from academics, it could be from medics, it could be governing bodies or school of thought, and any other things. So you have to keep an eye on these sources of key players in the field. The main idea or debate that is there in the field in that particular area of topic, and how is this particular thing changing over time. As I highlighted previously, that whenever we talk about review of literature, we get a time of around 1.5 to 3 years, and there is no doubt that during this particular course of time, when you started your research, you might have certain aspects that were not discovered earlier or that were not talked about earlier, and with due course of time, the whole pattern, or whole prescribing pattern, or the whole pattern of treatment has changed in a span of say 6 months to 1 year. Then, is there any problem with these ideas or debates? Is there a problem with the methodology? And you need to be different. That is would be your unique selling point. What are you going to do differently? That has to be the utmost important point in your review of literature. So when you talk about literature review, first you need to map down your story. You need to keep you need to have a brief idea about what your topic is. I've already highlighted about the key people, what are the key resources, what are the key ideas, methodologies that have been used, what are the strengths and weaknesses of existing research, and what will be your contribution. How will it be different? So if all these things, whatever you start a literature review, it is always advisable that you jot down notes with date. Or maybe if you're writing down on a computer, you need to save it as per date wise. This was a particular literature. Even you need to jot down the words that you searched on a particular search engine. Now there are various search engines such as Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed, when you talk about medical field, Cochrane database, Medline, and so on. So you need to jot down each and everything what you searched for, what were your keywords that you searched for. You can look for medical subject heading, and what was the subject heading that you put into it. Did you follow Boolean research? And always keep a note of it, because these notes are important. Once you start writing down, the review of literature is just a one-time process. It's a process that goes on. So you have to keep those notes ready with you, because by the time you have searched all the literature that is there, unless and until you have a very good memory or a very your learning is exponential, you will not be able to memorize, or you will not be able to write down exactly what you had thought earlier. So always jot down, and this could help you in further searching now. Now, the other thing that you need to do is, how do you read the material? You start with the big picture, start with the easier works first, and then skim the documents and identify major concepts. After you have a broad understanding of 10 to 15 papers, then you will start seeing a pattern. There would be, maybe let's say there would be a group of scientists who would be arguing or who would agree or would disagree with a particular process or a particular system. So these, this is just an example, hypothetical example, that some researchers think X causes Y, whereas others say that X is only a moderating variable. So you have to start with a broader area whenever you are reading material, and you'll have to jot down, or you have to come down, or you have to shrink yourself, you have to narrow down into 10 to 15 papers, and then you have further aspects. Always narrow your focus. Now, how you want to do that? That is totally on you. You want to go from a new material to old? That depends on you. You want to be general to specific? Again, that is totally your choice. Start with general topic, that is what I have been highlighting right from the beginning, which will lead to specific areas of interest and help develop understanding for your interrelationship of research. More the quality of journal output of author. As you read and become more informed on the topic, you will need to go back and do more focused searches. So that is why you need to jot down, you need to write down whatever you have found, and maybe you can keep a diary, or maybe you can keep a notes that are handy with date. It is always advisable. Sometimes what we tend to do is we tend to write down on a piece of paper. Even if you are writing it on a piece of paper, you should write down the sequence or order of the paper, and you should write down the date on which this particular paper was written. Think, analyze, and read out. Think about it. Think about now. When you look into 50 research papers, you will find, when you look thoroughly, go thoroughly, you will find that this particular paper is not pertaining to, or it is not of importance to my research question. You can read it out. Arrange to spend some review time with an experienced researcher in the field of study to get back. So that is where your guide comes, that is where your guide has a role. And you need to get feedbacks and to talk through any problems that are encountered by you. How do you want to read the material? The first thing that you need to do is read the abstract. All the research articles, they tend to give an abstract. So read the abstract, and the abstract will give you a brief idea whether this particular study or whether this particular article is of any help to you, or will it help you, or will it help further help you focus on your research question that you will come to know once you have read the abstract. So once you find it that this particular article is of interest, go ahead with the introduction. So once, if you go into the introduction, what you'll find is what is the reason, what is the justification for this particular study, and then it would provide you for certain other review and evaluation of relevant literature for that paper, which you can again go and check those papers also. Then you need to have a critical eye for the methodology. Focus on participants, measures, and procedures. Evaluate the results. Do you think the conclusions are logical, or do you detect any bias? And has this bias been highlighted by the researcher? So that is what you need to find out. If you go thoroughly through the paper, you will be able to figure it out. Take discussion with a grain of salt. So that means that there would be, you might find some flaws. You might find that the study has been edged for smoothing the process, and you have to pay attention to the limitations. This is very important. Limitations are an important landmark for a paper. If the paper highlights its limitation, that means that this particular paper, to an extent, is a genuine paper, or a paper that has been done thoroughly or rigorously, and you can focus on this particular paper also. Now, writing the review, you get an overview, design on organizing principles. Go for various, it could be themes, it could be trends, it could be methodology, it could be chronology, it could be controversies, and you can use a combination of some of them or all of them. Try to use headings. If you use heading for different sections of the review, it will give you a clear picture, and it will put your paper, your review of literature, in a proper perspective. Provide summative signpost of where your argument is leading. Like in the beginning, I told you that there's an introduction, there's a body, and conclusion. So your paragraph or your particular summative signpost, it provides you with an argument. Now, each step in review of literature tends to focus you more towards your research question. That is what has to be kept in mind. You need to summarize your review. You need to highlight the gaps in research. And then one step that is very important is editing and proofreading. So the editing and proofreading are fundamental aspects of good practicing. Editing is a process when you are continuously revising and improving your written work. It's often an activity that forms a major part of writing processes. Proofreading is a final check before printing and submission. It is a process that helps remove error and improve presentation. So I'll just focus on editing at this moment. So the best practice would be, you have written a review of literature and just keep it on the side. Keep it in somewhere in the drawer of your study table or somewhere, and bring it out after 1 week or 2 weeks. You'll find that there has been certain things and you can look into it. Because once you start writing about the review of literature, your thought process gets aligned. So, and then you think accordingly. You think according to the paper. You think according to your paper. You tend to get biased. So to avoid this bias, you can keep this paper. Once you have done with the editing, you can keep it on the side and you can again check it after 2 to 3 weeks. The other thing that is important is keep a draft of all the reviews that you have done with date. That would help most, that would help sort out most of your problem that is associated with. Then another thing that is important is the citation management tool. Now that would depend. There are two citation management out here. One is RefWorks, or the other is EndNote, and the other one is Mendeley's, is another process. So that will help you manage the reference and it will you which you are using. So there are various ways in writing the references in your research paper. Some of people start writing with the name of the author, some of them quote the author at the last. So that is totally depending upon the pattern that your particular institute is following. You can use a management tool, a reference management tool such as RefWorks or EndNote or Mendeley, because then all these references are stored in this particular tool. And whenever you write a line or you write something about this, the document itself takes that particular area from where you have taken the reference and it cites it. You have to create a list of reference, and these references have to be based on the required style. So when we talk about a good literature review, it should be concise, focused, logical, developed, integrative, and correct. So what is the focus? Focus is your topic. I've been highlighting right from the beginning. Start from broader area and narrow down. So talk about only those ideas and reports that are closely related to your topic. It should be concise. They should be, your idea should be presented economically. Do not take more space for presenting an idea. Don't keep on writing about it. You have to be very concise. You should know what is an extract from a particular paper that you need to write. You don't need to mention everything that is written on that particular paper. You have to be logical. The flow that is there within and among paragraphs should be smooth, logical, and there should be progression from one idea to next. There should not be a sudden shift. Do not leave the story half told. It should be integrate. Your paper should stress how the idea and the study are related. Focus on the bigger picture. What commonalities do all studies share? How are some studies different? How are some studies same? Your review should focus on work done on the cutting edge of your topic. Then there are certain common errors that are done in the review literature. One is hurrying through the review to get started could mean you could miss many things. Relying too heavily upon secondary sources. Concentrating on findings rather than methods. Overlooking other sources than academic journals. So you have to look into newspaper articles, blogs, books, magazines, everything. Searching too broad or too narrow, and inaccuracy in compiling the bibliographic information. So these are the various points that you need to keep in mind. These are certain references that are there. And I'll be getting back to you. If you have any questions or queries related to the topic, you can inbox me and I'll definitely get back to you. So I believe this is all from my side, and I hope that I have been able to solve some aspects for you. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.